Hello everyone and welcome back to Plague Inc. Evolved. Yes, and today we're doing a kind of tutorial because not everyone knows how to use the events lab. So because I use the scenario creator a lot, and I will give you that tutorial. So we're going to create a new scenario, and we just click all the labs on. And this is the most important one, the events lab. Allows you to create game-changing events and narrative pop-ups to for your scenario using powerful scripting tools. This is the most powerful tool in the whole scenario creator, if you know how to use it. Okay, this is the scenario data. You know, we all know what it is. If you ever use the creator, the disease lab, we all know what that is. The world lab, we all know what that is. And the government actions lab. Yeah, that's something new. But the only thing you can do with it is make the game more realistic and. Add new pop-ups. So it's only for the gameplay. So it has nothing to do with the gameplay. But if you want to do it, it makes the game your scenario more realistic. But the events lab. Yeah. Wait a second. Events lab. Events. Okay. So what we have here: create a new event, edit event name, duplicate select event and delete select event, and more options. Set default events. That's the first one. General narrative. So you can turn on and off all the vanilla game events that you don't want or you want. If you don't want it, you sync it, and if you don't want it, you leave the space blank. So. That's a good thing. Okay, we're going to add new events and we call it tester. Okay. All right, create event. And then we get this lovely stuff. Global conditions. The global conditions are the things that trigger your event. So for example, you can click on add condition. And okay, you can choose set variable, set random chance, set event triggers, or set tech triggers. Tech triggers are just the symptoms you need to evolve or not evolve for this scenario to happen. So if you use extreme bio aerosol, this event will trigger. So if you evolve extreme bio aerosol, this event will trigger. You can add more and more to make the event more complicated or something. So you can do a variable, and we a numerical variable. You can disease noticed, general, humanity population, disease stats. All the lovely stuff is here. So a lot of you people thinks how did I make the cure go down and upwards every time the cure reaches 100%. Well, let's do it like this. The cure, where's the cure? We will gaan even show advanced and show super advanced. And then we do cure, we type cure. Cure, complete percentage, select variable. And then if you're working with percentage, you can do a numerical value and to, and 1 is 100%, remember that. And if you want to do 79%, you type 1.79. Oh, well, 1.79. This is 79%, and you can add more and more more things. But you can do a variable, and then we do cure, a cure requirement, cure research. So if we have the cure complete percentage on 100, so we set this on 100%, on the 1. So if the cure reaches the most powerful tool in the events creator is math, not the party drug. I mean the things you learn on school and something. And and I forgot to tell, I'm not a native English speaker. So if I have a terrible Dutch accent, that's why. And if I say something wrong, sorry. Okay, so we have this one. It's bigger than. It means bigger than. So the cure petals need to be more than 100%. No, we don't want that. What we could do is do 0.79%. So like this. So if the cure reaches above the 79%, this event will pop up. So this event will trigger, you know. So we have this one. This is equals. This will only trigger if the cure resist is exactly on 79%. So if you want things to be above the thing, I would use this sign and you have the formula here. But if you use this one, the cure needs to be low. It needs to be smaller than 79%. Then this event will trigger always. So we don't do that. And this is not equals not. So if you start to do a scenario, you know your math, right? So we use the bigger than sign. This is equal bigger than equals, smaller than equals, equals not. Yeah, okay, we know all the stuff. Okay, alright. So now we're going to country conditions. This event will only happen if the code finds a country to meet other country conditions. It's basically the same as the global conditions, but this only counts for per country. This only counts per country if I said it correctly. This only count so if the game finds a country that meets the country conditions, this event will pop up also. So yeah, we won't use these ones. And then we outcomes. You can make everything happen, like flying cars, super diseases, Superman, superheroes. Everything your nasty little mind will come up with. So outcomes, outcomes is empty. So we can set a variable like this one, if the cure reaches 100%, above 79%, we will use the cure and have so a cure requirement multiplier select variable multiplier equals maybe 20. So 20. So you will need 20 times more the cure. That's too much. 10 times more cure research than you already have. So the cure will pop back to like 14% or something if you do something. So if this triggers, the cure reaches 100%, which is almost 100%, it will be set back, and then you can also set variable. And then we choose a variable, and like disease effects, disease stats. So we increase infectivity. How about that? Infectivity plus okay. So we have the equals. So it sets it to that number no matter what. Plus, it will add the number you type in here. Number of value type for about 10. So it will add 10 to the infectivity you already have. Minus it will remove 10 points from your from the infectivity you already have. Times so it will you will have 10 times the infectivity you already have if you use a number 10. And divide. You will divide the your infectivity by 10 so there is nothing left. We will use plus 10. And then we use then the last one we use a news pop-up. So what you can do here, you can customize everything. You can trigger pop-up yes or no, pop-up tile. Oh my gosh, more infectivity. Oh my gosh. Okay, so and now you can type something in here, and then you can add your own Like we're going to program files, we're going to fraps. I keep all my things in the fraps. So we use then cure1. This is the one I used for the Rise of the Xenomorph scenario. If you haven't seen that or subscribed to it, I will leave a link in the description. So it's a very high rated scenario, so I would recommend it. And I will play it in the future myself sometime. So because I'm very selfish. I'm very selfish and posh, so I play my own scenario. So you can icon, you can customize everything you know and love about it, and you can in new content this will flash up in the upper left, and it says something like oh my gosh, and this will pop up in the left bar if this event is triggered. That's basically how to use it, and you can add event. Oh, and then the last thing, you can add event, and that is pre-test. And this you can do. Think about this is the event that we made before this, if you want to, if one test to occur, you need pretest has to be used first. So cancel. So we use set event triggers, and then you can select an event that you already made, and apply that. So this event will only trigger if pretest has already triggered. So if pretest has triggered. And all the other global conditions are true, then this event will occur and it will say, oh my gosh, no more infinitivity. You know what I mean? Does everyone understand this? If you have any questions, leave a comment, I will answer them. And that's basically how to use the event slab. So, close, yes. Thank you so much for watching. I hope my English wasn't too bad, because I'm doing my best. I don't know English very good. I don't English good. I don't feel really English good. So, okay. All right. So, thank you for watching. I will see you all next time with more Plague Evolved. And, this was my little tutorial of the Events Lab by RMS007. My name is RMS007, if you haven't noticed yet. I am Emerus 007 and I'm very bad at English. I'm not good at English. I suck at English. Hey, good one. I am not good at English. So, okay. Thank you for watching. I'll see you all next time with another Plague Evolved video. So, bye bye!